सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे YouTube चैनल शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन लीगल मैटर्स को और दबाइए इस बेल को ताकि आपको मिल सके हमारा वीडियो सबसे पहले और यह बिल्कुल फ्री है। रेडी स्टार्ट। मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई मस्ट प्लेस ऑन रिकॉर्ड माई ग्रेटफुल थैंक्स टू द यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट्स कमीशन फॉर द वर्क दैट दे हैव डन फॉर the advancement of higher education. They have done good work and in full cooperation with the education ministry. This, I think, must encourage state governments to establish university grants commissions or committees in their respective states. What the country needs most is the coordinated efforts of the autonomous university grants commissions working in harmony with the state governments and university authorities. Coordinated efforts are needed to bring about certain uniformity in the standards of university education. Without that, our educational advancement is bound to suffer from various tensions and difficulties. I do agree with my friend that the annual report under discussion is rather a dull report. At least it is not as bright as the two previous reports were. In the previous two reports, the University Grants Commission invited the attention of the nation to certain academic problems, to certain educational needs. Unfortunately, in this report, the University Grants Commission confines its remarks mostly to what has been achieved in the field of university education. Under the guidance and with the assistance of the University Grants Commission. However, sir, it is not possible for me to agree with Mr. Santhanam that the University Grants Commission should not extend help to universities for the preservation of manuscripts. Manuscripts are of great importance so far as university libraries are concerned. It is the duty of universities to preserve those manuscripts and it is the duty of the University Grants Commission to extend to universities the necessary financial assistance for maintaining and preserving the manuscripts in good order. Also, it is not possible for me, sir, to agree with my friend that today universities are enjoying too much of autonomy. I agree with the University Grants Commission which 2 years ago remarked that freedom is vital for education and democracy, and I personally feel, sir, that on one plea or the other, university autonomy and academic freedom are being restricted rather than being extended as they must be. I do not think, sir, that a social purpose or a social value can be imparted in the teaching by a teacher through the imposition of restrictions on his freedom of thinking. I feel that teachers need academic freedom for discharging their duties in an efficient way. If we take into consideration the affiliated colleges, we will notice that the teachers are subjected to such humiliating conditions that it is not possible for them to discharge their duties to their students, to impart to their students any sense of responsibility or any moral values in their lives. I, therefore, sir, feel that it is not necessary to be more careful about the preservation of academic freedom to teachers. Sir, we are grateful to the Education Ministry and to the University Grants Commission for upgrading the salaries of teachers in the central universities. Yet a great disparity prevails in the salaries of teachers of central universities and state universities and affiliated colleges, and this disparity is causing a lot of heart burning and a lot of difficulties. As one connected with education, I may say that there is not much a marked difference in the quality of teachers serving in the central universities and in the state universities and in affiliated colleges as to justify the great disparity in the salaries of teachers of these institutions. I feel, sir, that we must keep in our mind the remarks of the University Grants Commission made in their earlier annual report with regard to teachers' salaries. We are not only to provide adequate salaries to teachers of affiliated colleges, but also to teachers of secondary schools. We must remember, sir, that a great majority of students study in affiliated colleges, and the quality of education is largely determined by the quality of work that is done in affiliated colleges. For improvement in the quality of teaching, improvement in living conditions is also very necessary. The University Grants Commission has invited our attention in its report to the appalling conditions in which teachers have to live. But unfortunately, the University Grants Commission has to admit that it does not seem likely that we shall be able to make anything more than the marginal contribution towards this practical need. I feel that the University Grants Commission should pay more attention to the solution of this problem than has so far been paid by it and the Education Ministry, and that the government should not grudge funds to the University Grants Commission for making adequate arrangements for improving living conditions of teachers who are expected to train the citizens of the country. Sir, in the University Grants Commission report, it is maintained that ₹12,000 should be granted to every affiliated college for the welfare of the teaching staff, and that efforts should be made to provide them with quarters, and that too in the vicinity of the college where they teach. Stop.